class 7 in the previous video lesson we have already started with echo. We have learned the conditions for formation of echo. Now remember I have left till the portion where I say that the minimum distance should be 17 meter in a year. Why is this so? Why if it's less than 17 it cannot happen echo, we will not be able to hear an echo. What did I say that echo is heard, we say it's an echo when we can differentiate between the original sound which is being made and the repetition of the sound. We can very well distinguish the two sounds. It's not that they are, these two are mixed up and we get to hear a mixed sound. Okay. Now our brain can, it you know, persists any sound. Say I am producing a sound, so that effect of that sound is registered in our brain for 1 by 10 seconds. That means in that time if any other sound is made, then we are not able to distinguish the two sounds. That time is known as persistence of hearing. I don't know whether you have read it in biology or not. That is known as persistence of hearing. That means our brain persists, it registers the effect of any particular sound for 1 by 10 seconds. That means in this 1 by 10 seconds, if any other sound comes, our brain cannot differentiate between the two sounds. That is why, suppose I am standing here, I am producing a sound, this is a reflector, okay? Sound is traveling, striking the reflector and bouncing back to my ears. Now, let the speed of sound in ear is 340 meter per second. 340, now this, in your book, it's, I think it's given in 344. Actually, you know, speed of sound in ear, it can vary due to the temperature. With the increase or decrease in temperature, moisture, many other factors, speed of sound may change. So let us assume that standard it is 340 meter per second. Minimum time to hear echo, 1 by 10 seconds. Why? If I am producing the sound and if within this 1 by 10 seconds, if that reflected sound comes back to me, what will happen? Will I be able to distinguish between the two sounds? No. I will be able to distinguish between the two sounds only when it comes at least a time 1 by 10 seconds or greater than that. That means a minimum is 1 by 10. It can be more than that, but at least it should be 1 by 10 seconds. My brain will need to register that previous sound for 1 by 10 seconds. What is the total distance traveled by the sound? I am making the sound, it's traveling, striking the reflector, coming back to me. If the distance between me and the reflector, that is the source of sound, and the reflector is small d, then what is the total distance traveled? D plus d. Sound is produced, sound is traveling towards the reflector, d distance, striking and reflecting back, traveling again d distance, isn't it? D plus d, 2 into d. So the total distance is 2 into d. Do you remember distance is equal to speed into time? Remember this, right? Can I write then distance is equal to speed into time? So d equal to 34 by 2, 70. That means the minimum distance has to be 17 meter in air. Because what have we learned? Speed of sound varies in different mediums. In air it's something, in water it will be something, in a solid it will be something. So in air the minimum distance should be approximately 17 meter. Okay, so I won't give this derivation in your exam, but just try to understand. We'll repeat it once again in the next classes also, not in class 8, I think in 9 or 10. So, but still, just try to understand that why am I saying that the minimum distance in here should be 17 meter. Now, can you guess that if suppose the distance between the source of sound and the reflector is less than 17 meter in here, reflected sound may reach the listener's ears, but it's reaching within that 1 by 10 seconds. That is why not able to distinguish between the two sounds. That's why we will say that echo is not formed. The example which I gave, that repetitive reflections, that means multiple reflection from many reflecting surfaces, not produce echo, because that sounds, with reflected sounds, are received, not received after this 1 by 10 seconds. Because see, suppose you have sound is made and you have a lot of high-rise buildings, multiple reflections from the different reflecting surfaces are reaching to you, and you find a effect which is produced, such as a prolonged sound is produced. That means you have produced a sound, and that sound finally, due to this repetitive multiple reflection from the different reflecting surfaces, it's producing a prolonged sound wave. That is known as reverberation. Okay. So reverberation you don't have in your syllabus. Like, it's just a small keynote given. So I just wanted to tell you that, you know, when multiple reflections, we can utilize this phenomena by producing multiple reflections from different reflecting surfaces in order to enhance the original sound. Because in reverberation, what happens, unlike echo, two sounds are not distinctly heard. That's why we don't call it echo. The sounds, the original sound and the reflected sounds, are heard at the same time. That is within the time interval of 1 by 10 seconds. That's why your brain cannot differentiate between the sounds. So what happens, some musicians, they use it in order to enhance the sound which they are producing. So because ultimately it will produce a prolonged and a much enhanced sound. Okay, so that's the reverberation. And just a small brief idea about reverberation. So what is echo? I hope it's clear to you. And what are the conditions for formation of echo? Let's learn a short application of echo. When the ships are ships, they carry a device known as full form sound navigation and ranging. What is that? This device can transmit ultrasonic waves. Remember ultrasonic waves? High frequency, greater than 20,000 hertz. So we are not able to hear those sounds. So this sonar, suppose this ship is carrying this sonar. Okay, the ship is carrying the sonar. It will produce ultrasonic waves. This ultrasonic waves will reach the bottom of the sea. So this is the and it will reflect back, right? Now, where the ones who are operating this, if they calculate the time which the sound is taking, they have sent the ultrasonic waves and they note the time in which the sound is being reflected back and is received back. Suppose they have noted the time as t, and they know the speed of sound in water, right? The speed of sound in water they know. Say whatever, say it is x. Can they calculate the distance, the depth of the sea then? Can they? Yes. How? It's traveling, the sound wave is traveling and reflecting back. So what is the total distance travel? Say this is d, then d plus d, 2d. So 2d equal to x into t, d equal to x into t by 2. So therefore, they use this method to find the depth of the oceans. This is known as ranging. Sound, this device used is known as sound navigation and ranging. Okay, so I won't give you numericals using sonar. I know you have a solved example in your book where the sonar has at the end of the chapter, I think, a numerical example with sonar is given. I won't give you, okay? You won't get those type of numericals. Simple reflection of sound numericals you can get. For example, let's see, you will be able to understand better, okay, if you do this. A boy fires a gun and hears the echo 2 seconds later. If he is 350 meters away from the wall, say the boy is standing here, this is the wall. He fires a gun, sound is produced, sound is traveling, hitting the wall, reflecting back. Okay? If he is 350 meters away from the wall, calculate the speed of sound. Can you tell me then what is the total distance traveled by the sound? The boy is 350 meters away from the wall. Distance between the boy and the wall is 350 meters. So, sound is going, striking the wall, reflecting back. What is the total distance traveled by sound then? 350. Reflecting back, again 350. So, total distance traveled by sound plus 350, 700 meter. Isn't it? And he hears the echo 2 seconds later. He has fired the gun. After 2 seconds, he can hear the echo. That means the time taken for the reflected sound to come back is 2 seconds. Then can I write 700 is equal to speed into time. Can I write distance is equal to speed into time? Speed I don't know, but time is given. Time is 2 seconds. So therefore can I write speed is equal to distance by time? That is equal to 350 meter per second. Meter per second. Because it's a speed. Distance by time. Distance is in meter, time is in seconds. So meter per second, okay? I hope you remember this. Second. Distance is in meter. Distance is in meter and time is in second. So meter per second. Right? Say this one. A girl claps. Say I'm the girl. I'm clapping. I have a cliff 660 meter away from me. The cliff is 660 meter away from the girl. The cliff acts as the reflecting surface here. Okay? Now, That means if this is the girl, this is the cliff. Distance between the girl and the cliff, 660 meter. The girl is clapping, sound is produced, sound is going, striking the cliff and reflecting back to the girl. After which, she can hear the reflected sound, which is an echo. That means it's coming after the minimum time required to hear the echo. It's given. Can you tell me the total distance traveled then? Total distance traveled by sound? Sound waves coming back again. Sound going, reflected sound. 660 plus 660, isn't it? Isn't it? Sound is produced by the girl after clapping. Sound is traveling. Cliff is a reflector. It's reflecting back the sound to the girl. So 660 plus 660. Now, speed of sound now is given. So what do we know? Isn't it? Distance is 1320 equal to, speed is given 330. Time we have to find. Calculate the time taken. So therefore, time will be equal to 1320 divided by 330, right? 1320 divided by 330. Obviously, 1320 divided by 330. Seconds answer. In 4 seconds, because we are finding the time. Distance, remember, in all the numericals, we will always give the answers in SI units, okay? So, now is the concept of this echo and reflection of sound clear to you? So, then, now from the sonar, as I've told you, you have a worked out example. See, from sonar. I won't give you numericals from sonar, okay? And also from this part, calculation of the minimum distance for formation of echo, I have shown you in the class, but in the exam, I won't give you, okay? So that you can understand, that's why I have demonstrated in the class. You learn the conditions for the echo, you learn the conditions, then what is echo, all these things you learn from echo. That means whatever we have done, you learn, just the portions which you won't learn, that I'll mention, okay? And from sonar also, a simple question, I'll do it with you, don't worry, I'll make you write in the class. And so that completes our chapter. So please go through the video lessons. If you find any difficulty in understanding any part, ask me, and then we'll move on to the question answer section. And 2 numericals already I have done with you. Copy these 2 numericals. And the remaining 3, this I already told you I won't give, F number 3 and F 1 and 2. This type of things I've already done in the video lesson. So, I want to give those as homework and I'll see who can do. So, I'll tell you when to do. First, for the time being, go through the video lessons. Okay? Go through the entire chapter and see if there is any part which you cannot understand. And as I've told you, loudness of sound, just study the part where loudness and amplitude are, the relation is given. Remaining factors you don't have to do. The rest of the thing I have told you. So just go through the entire chapter, go through the video lessons and see if there is any difficulty anywhere and then ask me. Then we'll move on to the parts, question answers, and I'll tell you what are the things which you will study for the exams. Okay.